In this lecture, we shall study about present tenses, the types of present tenses, and the rules we should follow to make sentences. Types of tenses. There are three main types of tenses: present tense, past tense, and future tense. Each of them can be divided into four further categories. Present tense. In this type of tenses, an activity is related to take place in the present period of time. There are four types of present tense. Number 1, present indefinite tense. Number 2, present continuous tense. Number 3, present perfect tense. Number 4, present perfect continuous tense. Other name of present indefinite tense are the present tense, the simple present tense, or the present indefinite tense. Present indefinite tense. In this type of tense, mostly a sentence is made to show the regularity of work or a kind of fact. For example, I work in the admin department. They teach English. The sun rises in the east, etc. To write a sentence in present indefinite tense, a structure should be followed, which is subject plus first form of verb plus object. This structure is only used for first person singular, second person singular, third person plural, second person plural, and first person plural. It means this structure does not use for third person singular. For example, we love her cat. I sing a song. These are first person. They watch a movie. Third person plural. You always wake up late. Second person. They pick cotton in summer. Third person plural. The structure for third person singular is subject plus first form of verb plus S or ES plus object. It means here when we are using first form of verb, we should add S or ES. The second type of present tense is present continuous tense, which have other names: the present continuous tense, present indefinite continuous tense. In these type of tenses, continuity of the verb is used. In present continuous tense, structure or ruling is used as subject plus is or are or am plus first form of verb plus ing plus object. Here, is, are, or am are the helping verbs. And with the first form of verb, ing should be added. For example, we are playing with her cat. Here, are is the helping verb and playing is first form of verb plus ing. I am singing a song. They are watching a movie. The words mentioned here in black color are first form of verb plus ing. Ahmed is plucking the roses. She is going to school. He is waiting for you. Helping verb is always used with a singular subject. Am is used with only I, and are is used only for the plural subjects. Present perfect tense. In this type of tenses, it shows work is done recently. It means an action is taken place but at recent period of time. The structure is used to describe this type of tenses is subject plus has or have plus third form of verb plus object. Whenever we use third form of verb, it means the work has been done. The helping verb has or have are used to show the work has been done recently. Helping verb has is always used for the third person singular, and the helping verb have is always used except for the third person singular. Let's have a look on given examples. We have played with her cat. Here played is a third form of verb and have shows the plural subject. I have sung a song. They have watched a movie. Ahmed has plucked the roses. Here Ahmed is a third person singular due to which we used has. And the verb plucked is used to show third form of verb. She has gone to school. He has waited for you. Present perfect continuous tense. In this type of tenses, it shows work has been started from a specified time and still going on. It means started work has not finished yet. In these type of tenses, two type of helping verbs can be used, has been or have been. And the word since or for should be used to show the period of time. Word since is used when only starting point is specified, and the word for is used when total time is specified. So the complete structure is subject plus has been or have been plus first form of verb plus ing plus object plus since or for plus time or period. Here, first form of verb plus ing is showing the continuity of the work. For example, we have been playing with her cat since evening. I have been singing a song for half an hour. Ahmed has been plucking the roses since 5 o'clock. Here we used word since because starting point of time has been specified, but total time has not been specified. He has been waiting for you for 7 days. For is used because total time period is mentioned, which is 7 days. Thanks for watching my video. If you like my video, so please like, comment, subscribe and share. And if you like to watch any more upcoming videos, click on the bell button. Remember me in your prayers. Thank you.